Previously on the Jay and Dan podcast.
It's the Jay and Dan podcast brought to you by Playtex Gentle Glide Slender.
What? Mm-hmm. I put pictures of my on Twitter and she's like, why did you do that? I'm like, shut up, Mom. That's what we do.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's fine. The only thing I just wanted to tell you, if you don't mind, can you just photocopy the ownership while you're in there?
I don't know where a photocopier is.
Sean, are you 12 years old?
Mm-hmm. I got down here, son of a... I'm coming on! I'm coming on! I'm coming on!
Does he know you're revealing these stories?
He loves that this is happening.
Mm-hmm. I wasn't allowed to watch Three's Company.
What? Why were you allowed to watch? Too risque?
The living situation, everything was just too offside.
Just for too much. Mm-hmm.
Sad sack. Not a porn you want to watch.
You're listening to the Jay and Dan podcast.
Episode 27,
the Jay and Dan podcast, brought to you by Enusol.
Salt for your anus.
I don't think it's salt, it's just hemorrhoid medication.
Oh, is it? Okay. Enusol, is that really hemorrhoid medication?
Enusol, I found.
Enusol is a medication that can be used to treat hemorrhoids, also known as piles. Mom, I got the piles. Did you get the Enusol?
Heck!
Again, we're still searching for a sponsor.
We should point out that sponsors are lining up to sponsor us. That's our understanding.
Really?
Apparently they're lining up.
Well, could we let someone from the line in?
It's a little bit like the Jerome McGinley trade situation. Going into Wednesday night when we tape this podcast. A lot of leverage from different teams playing each other against each other, and I think that's what the TSN sales team's doing.
So right now we're like the club who creates the lineup outside, but no one's inside.
Exactly, Toolsy. That's us. And nothing going on inside.
But Mr. Bouncer, can I just go in and take a peek, see if anyone's there? Bear the cover. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, no problem. Just don't show up early. That's what you got to do. Well, this is going to be a good one, Toolsy.
Your mic sounds really echoey.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Oh,
we're here. Switching mics.
We're switching mics? Okay, here we go. Hello.
There,
hello. That's better. Yeah, okay, all right.
Was your mic on?
I think it was, yeah. Huh. Christoph is saying yes. By the way, Christoph back from a fabulous week in Jamaica, just smoking piles of ganj.
And eating the jerk chicken, man.
Wow.
No?
Can we hear that again?
Okay, before we get into onright swearing at all, the other night I did an intro. It made no sense for a top 10. I don't even know what the top 10 was. And Jay made a sound effect while we showed a picture of a red-headed man crying. And this was the sound he made.
That sounds like a man crying, doesn't it?
Sounds like a man who needs some Enusol in a minute. So that's going to be the sound effect for any swearing that may or may not occur.
Mom, I've got the piles.
I've never heard that reference. Got the piles.
I'm going to use that to get myself
out. Oh, it's now under the brand name Tuck.
Tux?
Anyway.
That's weird.
Mask cream.
You ever had hemorrhoids, Tools?
That's a personal question.
Oh, this is a personal
Speaking of asses.
Yep.
A gentleman sent me a tweet after the last podcast in which we sold the vehicle.
Oh, yes. And by the way, that did all go through. You weren't murdered.
Yes, everyone wondered if I was murdered. Very nice kid. Sean was here with his dad.
Well, after we recorded episode 23, he came up here. And yes, he did appear to be 12 years old.
So anyway, this guy went after me on Twitter. He's like, oh, so you're just going to pocket the money? You ever think of giving it to charity? I've lost all respect for you. First off, I can do whatever the F I want with the money.
Okay, couple of things. $600? Do you think this is going to
cure cancer?
Yeah, he's like,
cancer?
Oh, the Cancer Society couldn't have used it? Like, just a complete ass. It ruined my week because of one human.
You are so sensitive.
Anyways, if he must know, it went to a close associate, someone that I know, who needed money for repairs for their car. They found out 5 days too late. I could have just given my car, but instead I gave the money to them to fix their vehicle.
Oh, now you're a hero. I guess we should all pile on. I don't know what that meant.
So, buddy, who you know who you are, go to hell. He's like, I'm never listening to this podcast again.
Trust me.
Yeah, that's the guy. That's him. This is a complete quad.
Buddy, who you know who you are.
But I guess he's not listening, so. But he's going to tune in to listen, I'm
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, he'll tune in to see. And now you just fed into everything he wanted. You mentioned him.
No, I didn't mention who he was. I didn't.
He's Buddy Who You Know Who You Are on Twitter. At Buddy Who You Know Who You Are.
Jay and I had a very romantic dinner before we came here.
Absolutely, we did.
I was doing my taxes, and I called Jay. I said, have you eaten yet? He says, I just finished. I said, perfect. I showed up, and he had to sit and watch me eat.
It was good, though. And then they brought us out, because we're low-level Q-list celebrities. We went to Momofuku Noodle Bar. Christoph, we have to take you there next week. And Adrian, by the way, is here.
Adrian sitting in for Mike.
Mike Gentile, little illness in the family, so he's taking care of that. And Adrian's here. And Adrian, by the way, just graduated from Centennial College Broadcasting. Is that right, Adrian? Oh, wait. We have another mic for her. I was like swinging my mic around.
Yeah, that's correct.
And my understanding is that, so Jim Taddy was one of your instructors?
Yeah, he taught us for 2 semesters.
And Dan and I came in to speak at one point, and what happened?
I slept in.
Yeah, that's great.
Great to hear. It's a good story.
What happened when you got back to class? Was everyone like, yeah, you didn't miss much?
Perfect response. Just leave it at
very
that.
Good.
Leave it at that.
You've already filled in admirably, Adrian. Very nice. Thank you for filling in today.
Anytime.
Okay. So you say I get sidetracked. You're in the middle of talking about a meal.
Yeah, Momofuku Noodle Bar. So this is the famous Korean-American chef David Chang from New York City. He's like the most famous kind of chef of his generation. He's opened these restaurants in Toronto now, and they're fantastic. And that was your first time going there, right?
Yeah, I showed up, and the waitress was at the table, or at the bar where we were sitting. Because we get completely annihilated before everybody. I'm kidding. There's the only seats left in the place.
We had 2 beers.
So I came in, and I thought you were making fun of me because I was a hayseed. You're like, yeah, he's going to have the chicken wings. And I'm like, we're at like a... They don't have chicken wings. But they had chicken wings.
Oh, they were good.
They were really good.
Holy man.
The whole reason I brought this up was we stopped at Tim Hortons on the way to the studio. We sat down at a table because we already spent enough time together. Why not spend a few more hours? And we were approached by a gentleman who ran for mayor in Toronto, the last mayoralty race.
That's right.
He's running again.
DeWitt Lee is his name.
DeWitt Lee. DeWitt, he got like 1,500 votes last time, and he said he would have had more, except he had 2 signs. Someone stole one of the signs.
You know, that happens. And he called politics a dirty game because of it.
And then he proceeded to interview us on his camera.
So look for that interview somewhere on the internet.
How will we ever find that?
What did he say? It was like something sports or I can't remember. Just look for DeWitt Lee and you'll find
really
it.
Really nice guy.
Super nice guy. His wife was with him. Nice guy. I'd vote for him. He'd be a hell of a lot better than the mayor we have
now. Whoa, easy now.
Why not, eh?
I wish he was our mayor.
Speaking of Tim, he's got to roll up the room here.
You're going to do it with your teeth? Speaking of hayseeds.
Well, how do you roll it up?
With my fingers?
What? Oh, what do we got?
How do you roll up the rim? I'm gumming it. I wish I put my dentures in.
Whenever I see the again, I always want to think it's going to say you won again, but it's never that. It's please play again.
Yeah. Tim's has become a big, this whole roll up the rim thing is as much a part of Canadiana is Mr. Dress-Up.
CBC, I watched CBC Suppertime News the other day, and they did a story on Roll Up the Rim.
You're the only one.
They did a story on Roll Up the Rim.
Is this the one with Dwight Drummond?
Yeah.
Wow, Dwight Drummond.
And they, I think the gist of the story was you win more on bigger sizes. They were like...
That's what she said.
No! Sick of that.
Adrian's like, I wish I had stayed in school.
I wish I had slept in for this. I got to go to Chuck E. Cheese on the weekend.
Oh. You did finally get to Chuck E. Cheese. This wasn't your daughter's birthday. It was like someone else's.
No, it was my niece. We missed it the previous week because we were all sick, so we took her to Chuck E. Cheese.
Nice.
And let me say... It's a harboring ground for future gamblers. That's all it is.
How so?
Because you buy your tokens, and you want to win your tickets.
Oh, yeah,
so
yeah.
My daughter stopped playing. We found there was a life-size version of the Operation game, where you had to drop the thing down, and you get like 16 tickets if you get into the one. So she stopped playing. She's like, this is where you win the most, so can you just keep winning these?
Wow.
So
you could see her. She was jonesing.
Yeah, I know.
She was jonesing for more winnings.
And you know the other games that you always see them at the fair and stuff where you drop your coin in and a bar pushes it and all the coins are just hanging on the ledge. You're waiting for this big pile to be pushed off. But there's a magnet, obviously, keeping them on there. So she kept going back to this one. She's like, oh, they're all ready to fall. They're ready to fall.
Yeah, that's how they get you.
Oh, I was into it.
Yeah.
I was like, let's get some more tickets.
Can't wait till you start hanging out at Chuck E. Cheese every afternoon.
That's creepy. So we won 230 tickets. That's good enough for a two fun dips and a curly straw. So we come back and my mom's there. She's like, but you had so many tickets.
Yeah, it's pathetic. But
my daughter's standing there. She thought, like, this was a haul. I'm like, yeah, didn't she do good? She's like, yeah.
Yeah, great job. Fun dips for everyone.
So Chuck E. Cheese comes out, and he has to do this dance. They put on this ghetto blaster. He dances at the entrance, and then they throw up tickets.
Wait, is it a guy in an outfit?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
But he wanted no part of it. So this other guy, his handler, the mouse's handler.
Wait, he's got a handler?
He gets mobbed. Kids are coming up punching him. They're like, hey, Chuck E. Cheese, give me tickets.
Hey, you piece of...
Bull!
I just wanted to entertain!
So, he was not into the dance. He was, like, giving it a half-ass effort. So his handler's like, hey, Chucky, you pull a hammy? So he finally started getting it going a bit.
Oh, my God, that's great.
And then a few of them got pictures. The back kitchen staff, mm-hmm. big fans of Sports Center, and the one guy took a picture, and he tweeted it. I wish I'd saved it. It's too far back to look now, but the gist of it was... TSN O'Toole was in today. The highlight of my 2 years in this prison.
Heck!
So that's Chuck E. Cheese in a nutshell. It's great if you're a gambler.
But otherwise, it's the most depressing
on
the planet.
It's not depressing. It's fun. If you're in and out like an hour, you get your fill.
Right. Chuck E. Cheese. If you're in and out in an hour, you won't be suicidal.
And they had beer taps, but I didn't want to be the one guy, like, carting around a pint. I'm like, hey, what's going on?
Hey, kids, win some more tickets. You're going to get yourself some fun dip. Hey, mouse, dance for me. Dance for me, you mouse.
Then I would start punching the mouse.
How are you a political prisoner?
I kicked a giant mouse in the butt. Do I have to draw you a diagram?
And then when you punch the mouse, it would make this sound.
So that was my experience. Chuck E. Cheese, you can sponsor the podcast.
Hey, we'd be happy to have you.
I don't know how many there are in the country. I don't think a lot.
I think every major city has a Chuck E. Cheese, no?
Really?
Yeah, Christoph is confirm. He's going to confirm this for us.
He's going on the interwebs.
See, that would be good, actually. That would work out well. I got a nice tweet from one of our listeners, Double Blumpkin, who said, "Hey, Jay, do you call your mom right or mom Dre?" It's a good question.
What do you call her?
The abandoner. She left me.
She didn't.
No, she didn't. My parents raised me. Pretty much had a normal childhood.
Is that the end of that story?
That's it.
Oh. If producer Tim had told that story, it would have taken 3 to 4 days.
I like to keep it concise. Speaking of which, producer Tim is back producing us now. It seems like I get the feeling he's told management he doesn't want to produce our show.
I can't badmouth him. He lent me Star Wars because my 5-year-old daughter was on the playground the other day. Her friends were playing Star Wars games. She's like, "What the hell is this? I don't know Star Wars."
Who's this? Jar Jar Binks? Who's that? Some sort of drunk?
So she came home, and I'm like, "I'll get you Star Wars." And you can't go to stores and rent DVDs anymore.
No, they don't exist. Those stores are gone, Tulsi.
So I emailed you. You said, "Leave me alone."
Yeah.
And you said, "I know who will have it. Tim.
Oh, yeah. He's got that.
Tim has like an Ewok sign version.
What?
It's signed by an Ewok. I'm kidding. It's not.
To Tim, thanks for supporting us on the moon of Endor.
While you were away, when James Duthie was co-hosting,
and subsequently scaring away our sponsors,
yes, yeah. he did the dunk. You heard the dunk tank,
yeah,
thing,
the
right?
Dunk tank.
You like the dunk tank? So,
and then he did the song. You like the dunk tank? So I was singing that the other day, walking around the house, and my daughter wanted to know what a dunk tank was, and then it came up in a commercial.
What?
Yeah, it's this commercial here.
Ever feel like your workday's never done? Newsflash, if you're driving a pickup, it's not. Because the second you're off the clock, you're dragging the dunk tank to the fall fun fest.
You like the dunk tank? You know, at the fair, the dunk tank.
It delivers the best combination of towing and fuel economy. So you get the power to do all the heavy lifting.
Oh, could you lift them up on the table?
No other truck's hitting that. Step right up. Introducing the new 2013 F-150.
Oh, what color?
That's perfect, isn't it?
That was really good.
That was very well done.
Maybe Ford will sponsor our podcast.
Ford or Dodge. It's a crapshoot at this point.
Hey, whichever one. Hey, or Suzuki, which has just stopped this week selling cars in Canada.
Did they?
Oh, what color?
Thanks to everyone who goes to the Senators games and sends us pictures of the Dodge Dart that drives out during the intermissions. We love those.
It always gives me a chuckle. Lot. Yeah, that is pretty good.
So Dennis Leary, what would you get paid for voicing a Ford commercial if you're Dennis Leary?
One thing I should tell all of our listeners that Toolsy's obsessed with what actors get paid for commercials. You are pretty obsessed with this.
Because we have no idea.
No, it's true. It is something that, because you're told not to ask people what they make for things. You know, everyone says, well, don't talk about money. It's impolite or whatever.
Well, I'm not asking what anyone makes of the job. This is like a side job for guys like Dennis Leary and all the people that voice the car
I would say, I'm going to guess a couple hundred grand.
Like $200,000 to $300,000
a
year.
Yeah.
He has to go into a booth
Into a booth 3 times, doesn't even wear clothes. There's an Ewok while he's reading the script. Is that too much? Some people have it.
His firefighter show over? Is it? Backdraft?
I believe so. I got...
No, his show wasn't Backdraft.
No, it's called Rescue Me?
Yeah. I watched it for a few seasons. Pretty good.
Good show.
Yeah.
Good
show. Producer Tim loved that.
Yeah. Producer Tim. Oh, Game of Thrones starts this Sunday. Oh, Adrian's into it. Yeah? Big fan? Oh, what a show. Dinklage was on The Daily Show the other night. Bit of an awkward interview. Great actor. Questionable interview. He just didn't seem happy to be there. Dinklage. But I do love him.
I don't watch it.
Why don't you watch that show? Everyone watches it. It's so good.
I don't want to follow the crowd.
Yeah, you're very much your own man.
I just watch the earlier version of it, My Pet Monster.
Kate Burness is... Well, we have like 4 guests on the on the podcast today.
Whoa.
Okay, we have Kate Burness.
We're giving in to Newfoundland Raider fan.
This guy. So Newfoundland Raider fan on Twitter... 4 tweets today alone. Are you guys having her on today? Yeah.
What's he going to do when she's on?
God, I don't know. All I know is he'll be naked and rubbing himself in an Ewok costume. So Kate just said she's making a quick run to DQ. She'll be back in 15.
Oh,
so,
I can't wait to hear what she got. I'm going to say Blizzard. The go-to order.
I'm going to say Beirness is going to crush like a something different, like a blueberry sundae or something.
No. Yeah. Peanut Buster Parfait.
Yeah.
Not a Peanut Buster Barfait.
Oh, the old Barfy. How about a Hot Fudge Brownie Delight?
That's not bad.
Tasty. So she's going to be on. Your brother, Sean, is going to be on.
That's right. He's going to go further in depth as to why we couldn't watch Three's Company, because I'm sure he knows a bit more than I do, since he's the oldest.
And then we're also having Jeremy Taggart, of course, with another old man story. And then finally, who's our fourth one? I forget now.
Melissa Grelo?
Oh, yes. Grelo is coming on. Is Grelo on now? Grelo, are you here?
I'm here.
Grelo, a couple of things. Right off the top, did you get my message about Dan's email to you about the flowers? You don't bring me
flowers. Yeah, I did. And Dan, I think you need to check if there's any filters or whatnot on your email, because I replied not once, but in fact twice.
Whoa!
With very valuable information regarding flowers and flower shops in the vicinity.
Wow.
And no reply. So I thought you were giving me the cold shoulder.
Wow.
Wow, Grelo. And see, we thought that you were creeped out that Dan was creeping.
Because here's the reason. Because I said I wanted to get my girls flowers, and I didn't specify my wife and two daughters. So I thought maybe you were like, oh my God, he's bringing all the ladies here flowers? So I thought I had offended you.
Oh, first of all, I'm not easily offended, and well, and that would have been sweet, really, actually, if you think about it.
Yeah,
but
kind of creepy.
No,
though,
I thought you kind of got, you know. Listen, I said Dan's a very popular man. He probably is inundated with emails. Mine got lost in the shuffle. I didn't take it personally.
Wow, Grelo, you are so not right about any of that.
I usually get 2 emails a day. One of them is Jay telling me that he's just bought NOS or is going to buy NOS, and then the other one is usually from my mom.
That's very nice. And what, your family is not in there? Your wife's not in there?
No one has any contact with me. So you not responding, well, now that I find you did, but it made a lot of sense because I get a lot of that.
Yeah.
I see.
He genuinely thought that you had been creeped out by Umbrella.
Well, I'm glad we cleared that up. I feel so great.
Isn't this great? This podcast has been a huge success.
We, Grelo, we always say this podcast is like therapy. We always discover something new about ourselves or clear up a problem, and we just did it right there.
Very nice. I'm glad I could help in that.
Okay, Melissa Grelo, for podcast listeners who don't know, you are the co-host along with Steve Anthony of CP24's morning show. We see you every morning. And this week, huge, huge news. You and 3 others, we'll get to the 3 others in a second, but you and 3 others have been named the new hosts of CTV's brand new daytime talk show, The Social. So congratulations on that. Take us through this a little bit. Tell us about The Social. And by the way, The Social, that doesn't mean a Winnipeg pre-wedding stag and stagette, right? Because that is called The Social.
You would be correct. You would be correct. That's definitely not what it is. Thank you, by the way, for those warm words. It was a very exciting week. You know, we kicked off the week with this big announcement on Monday. And I got to say, as not only somebody who works in television, but someone who is an avid consumer of television, I feel like a show like this is long overdue. So I'll break it down for you. Essentially, we are a daytime talk show that's getting added to a great lineup that already consists of great personalities and women, quite frankly, like Marilyn Dennis. Our show is similar and yet very, very different. So what's similar? We're on the daytime. We are national across CTV's fabulous network across this country. But that's pretty well all that we have in common, because we are going to be a daytime talk show that is very, very inspired and driven, quite frankly, by social media. And so I know you guys are really big on Twitter, a lot of people who are on Facebook, and even though I feel like Facebook is going the way of voicemail, but that's a different discussion, and Instagram, and even things like email and texting. And we are really inspired by the conversations and the engagements that happen through social media. Now, how does all of this intersect? So we will be talking about the top stories of the day, be it the top news stories, whether whether it's a new pope that, you know, they're selecting in the Vatican, or whether it's giant pandas landing in Toronto, and what the heck does that have to do with China and oil and Canada? Or maybe it's Rihanna, you know, posting butt-naked pictures of herself all over Instagram. I mean, whatever the top stories are of the day, we're going to be tackling them in a way that only we can. And speaking of we, I know you mentioned my co-host. I've got to mention that we have a phenomenal panel of hosts. I'll be joined with Cynthia Loist, who is currently the co-host on Inner Space on Space Channel. She's also a sex and relationship expert. So, gentlemen,
if you have any questions
ever, she's the girl. She knows what she's talking about. She also happens to be 8 months pregnant. So she is going to be, when we launch the show, a brand new mom. So she's going to bring all of that sensibility and all that experience and probably a lot of sleeplessness to the show. Also be joined by entertainment reporter Tracy Melchor, who is the comedian of the group. She is going to knock your socks off. She's hilarious. And finally, famed celebrity blogger Lainey Louie, who is also with E-Talk, coincidentally, she'll be joining as well.
Now, is Lainey, I never got this confirmed, but is Lainey actually moving from Vancouver to Toronto, Mel?
You would be correct.
Wow.
What? Deal.
She's making the move. She's finally... We had her on the podcast before, and I know she's been reluctant to move out, but she's making the move. Good for
her.
Are
you drinking a cocktail?
Well...
It's okay.
Actually, yeah.
Yeah? What is it, Mel? What's the drink?
Listen, they don't call me Malibu Melly for nothing, so it's my Malibu and Diet Coke.
Oh, that sounds like a nice nightcap.
That's how I roll, considering I only slept an hour and a half last night, so I want to make sure I don't have a repeat. So I'm
just get canned.
Yeah. Just got destroyed, Mel. Now, speaking of that, so you are going to continue on CP24 Breakfast in addition to doing the social. So, like, how much sleep are you going to get? You're literally the hardest working human at Bell Media.
No, I definitely am not one of the hardest working, although you guys can attest to this. When you love your job, it never actually feels like you're working and you just want to do more of it. I don't know. Maybe I'm talking out of line there.
It's very sweet of you to say, anyway. Very sweet of you to say, but we are probably the least hardworking.
So, Grelo, I'm going to join you here. There we go. I'm cracking one.
No, that's your Nas or whatever you guys drink on your show.
That's right.
We've actually gotten to like the new flavored Red Bull.
Really?
It's actually not bad, Mel.
I'm having the cranberry this time.
But listen, sorry to interrupt there, Dan, but I know that you were having some like heart issues, so I don't know if Red Bull is really the thing that you need to be consuming right now.
It's sweet of you to keep tabs on me. I do appreciate that. You're right. I was having some minor heart palpitations. Were they directly related to my consumption of 1,000 milliliters of energy drink per day? Maybe not.
But you also have like five coffees in the morning, don't you?
Perhaps.
Me?
At least an Easter.
Oh,
yeah.
You need to stop that.
I also consume at least one or two Easter cream eggs a day. God, those are delicious. So all in all, my diet is pretty exemplary.
Before we came to do the podcast, before we went to the Tim Hortons, we stopped at a convenience store and Jay was looking for an Easter cream egg, but there was a communication problem. Translation problem with trying to find the cream egg. We were shown everything else in the store, but there was no cream egg.
I was sweating, Mel. It was like a heroin addict looking for crack.
Wow. Yeah. So what did you settle for?
I settled for a caramel.
Oh, we still have those chocolate bars.
Yeah, they're melted.
Bad. Listen, it's not bad.
No, it's not bad at all. So, okay, Mel, we're going to let you go because we know you have to get up bright and early tomorrow. But the social, when does it premiere on CTV in the fall? It's in the fall, right?
It will be in the fall. You know, that's we're still working out those details, but you guys will be one of the first to know. So just look out for it fall. It'll be live across the country Monday to Fridays on CTV.
And Mel, when my book Anchor Boy comes out in the fall, can I come on and promote it shamelessly?
Absolutely. Perfect. Absolutely. I mean, listen, who am I to say, but listen, if I have any weight on the show, then you will absolutely be on the show with open arms.
When my pamphlet comes out, don't do what I did. Can I come on?
Absolutely. That sounds compelling, Dan.
Thank you.
Mel, thanks for staying up a little later with us and enjoy that Malibu and Diet Coke. That sounds good. And say hi to Sultan for us.
I will. Cheers, guys. Thank you.
Take care.
Bye-bye. Yeah, Heard the distinct clinking of the ice on the glass.
You caught that. I'm impressed.
So Sultan's her dog.
Sultan is her dog, and she posts a lot of... He's a very cute dog, and she posts a lot of pictures.
What's
of
her
Sultan.
Twitter handle? We should give that
it's out. At Melissa Grelo. And you may also remember, some of our listeners across the country may remember Melissa. She was Seamus O'Regan's co-host in Whistler at the Vancouver Olympics.
Jay's stifling a burp right now.
I am. Oh, I should also mention that Christoph has handed me some very important information here. There are 14 Chuck E. Cheese's in Canada.
Just 14.
14. So. 9 of them in Ontario alone. 3 in Alberta, my home province. 1 in BC and 1 in Saskatchewan. 1 in the 306. There are 542 in the United States. We have a lot of American listeners, too, so that might tie in nicely, right?
Yep.
There's international locations in the United Arab Emirates, Chile, Guatemala, Mexico, Panama, and Saudi Arabia.
Does the mouse look the same in all of them?
Yeah, in all of them, the mouse is a smelly, sweaty costume. It's been worn and...
Can you join me? I'm drinking a little.
Oh, yeah.
Here.
Sorry, Toolsy. Here we go.
And everyone in Toronto will know Melissa Grelo from CP24.
Yeah.
You can see her every morning. So she wakes. She gets up when we get home.
That's right. Exactly. Sometimes I'll be up watching, you know, Fallon or whatever on the PVR. And she will tweet out, rise and shine, and I'll be like, not me. Good night, everybody.
You want to do our vintage commercial before we get to our next guest? I think we should.
Okay,
because
sure.
This is the one I requested last time, but you usurped me with Big League Chew last week.
Or Pro Stars, maybe?
Pro Stars.
Oh, Pro Stars.
So, yeah, we're going to do this one. It was a creepy doll. That came out.
Yeah.
You'll probably remember this song.
Yeah.
My buddy, wherever I go, he goes. My buddy, and me. Kiss sister, wherever I go, you're gonna go. Kiss sister, and me.
My buddy and kid sister. It's sold separately from Play School.
Kid sister?
This is great. Wait till you hear this recap of it. So My Buddy came out in 95. They stopped it in 1990. The doll is widely believed to be the inspiration for Chucky.
Well, exactly. I was thinking that. I was just thinking that. Why wouldn't it be, right?
Yeah. My Buddy doll was intended to... make dolls appealing to little boys and teach them about caring for their friends. So if you saw the commercial, this kid was toting around this doll and he like bring him up to the tree house. So he's hanging it by himself and his parents are like, yeah, he's got no friends. Maybe this guy will be his friend.
Like literally the whole premise was like, hey, boys might want to play with dolls. And you know what? Some boys did play with dolls, but those boys went on to be, you know, they were into other things. They were into dresses and stuff like that. And that was perfectly fine. There was nothing wrong with that. But you didn't need to market this doll to boys. Like, they were out playing. You know what I'm saying? Am I digging myself a big hole here?
Imagine bringing your first buddy over. Who's that? He's my buddy.
Yeah, he's my buddy.
Okay, we'll see you later.
Who wants to play with our buddies? Hey, you guys all got my buddies, right? What are you talking about, dude? That's a doll. Like, let's get the G.I. Joes out. Just disturbing as hell.
So that was a great trip down memory.
Yeah, I do distinctly remember that
commercial. Oh, everyone remembers that commercial.
Yeah, that was horrible.
So far, Chicken Tonight and My Buddy are the two catchiest tunes. I didn't remember the Big League Chew.
You didn't remember Big League Chew?
Well, I remember the product. I just didn't remember that song.
That's terrible. Should be ashamed.
I think we have our next guest already. It's the all-female edition of the podcast.
Who's on now?
Kate Beirness.
What? Beirness? What did you get at DQ?
I'm trying to eat it right now at the same time to talking to you, and I'm having a score blizzard.
Oh,
told you, blizzard.
Toolsy won.
Blizzard is the go-to menu item at DQ.
The worst thing is right now it's buy one, get one, 99 cents. So all I wanted to get was a mini, and my husband refuses to let me get a mini because of the deal.
Yeah.
So I had to get a big, huge one, and he promised he'd eat the rest of it. So.
He wanted you to get a big, huge one, I bet.
What, to fatten me up?
No, I was talking about something else.
They need to put those blizzards on sale once in a while because they're like $9, $10 a blizzard.
Are they? I have no idea.
Oh, you're too rich. You don't even care.
Yeah, Beirness.
Money means nothing to you.
You two are going to tell me I'm too rich.
Yeah, you're just too loaded, Beirness, living in your mansion. And
I don't have a mansion. What are you talking about?
Beirness, we're thrilled to have you on finally. And you know who's more thrilled than us to have you on? Newfoundland Raider fan who's obsessed with you.
Perfect. I'm glad. I'm glad I have some fans out there who vouch for me.
Do you get those tweets a day?
Of course. I think you guys actually get more than me.
Well, because he's obsessed with making sure that we have you on the podcast.
But he says he wants just the podcast to be classed up, and I find that's really nice of him.
Yeah, well, you do that.
Time to class it up.
And it's perfect timing because of March Madness. You worked, how long were your shifts for the first two rounds of coverage?
The first four were all the same because CBS decided that they were going to put like one game back to back on Saturday and Sunday, which didn't happen last year. And then they piled all the night games together. So it was the same for the first 4 days. We were on air on two stations for 12 hours.
Wow.
That was a lot. Like by the end of it, were you just physically and mentally drained?
No, I was ready to go. I was good. I have a lot of energy. I'm pretty good.
How do you have energy after working four 12-hour on-air shifts? Toolsy and I do 1 hour on-air shift five times a week, and we can't even handle it.
Yeah, no word of a lie when you tweeted that you'd need a month off,
Oh, yeah, big time.
Oh, yeah.
But you get to work with Sam and Jack. Sam seems, he's so laid back on air. I haven't gone down to say hi yet because it's
Are you scared of him?
No, it's a long walk.
Yeah. Lazy.
I am.
It is a long way between studios.
Great guy, though, seems.
It's so funny, eh? I was scared, you know what, Liz, like, to interview him, like, as a reporter. I saw what he did to reporters, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, man, I wonder what he's going to be like. Yeah, we're like bestest buddies now.
Really?
We're buds.
Have you brought up, have you played any of his old interview clips? Have you played the 0-0-0?
No, not yet. But like, I always said to him, I'm like, I was so glad I started at TSN and he had left, right? Because I'm like, I would have been so scared. He's like, Kate, you would have been fine. I just didn't like bad questions. Like, he just didn't like, if you asked him a stupid question, he didn't like it. So all he wanted was a good question from you.
Yeah.
So that was it.
Well, he was good, and the thing that I think we liked the most about him was just not only was he laid back, but he literally laid back while sitting on the desk. Like, it was almost like he was reclining.
So the first time we did the preview show, he's like, just to let you guys know, the lean's kind of my thing. Because I guess over at, like, TNT and NBA TV, you know, if you ever watch it, Kenny or Charles, right, they're just kicking back and relaxing, like, they're having a great time. So that's just his thing. And we're all like, all right, that's want to be your thing. That's perfectly fine. And he's just, I think he's fit in so well.
I love the lean's my thing. You should try steal it.
Me?
Yes.
Yeah, you should.
No. Okay, so you guys want me over the Sweet 16 or the Elite 8? You want me to start leaning?
Yes.
Okay, I'll try it once. I don't know. I don't know if our producer Dennis will go for that.
He'd love it. He loves us.
Our producer. Now, Dennis is one of our producers who doesn't like Dan very much.
He likes Dan. That's a lie.
He's not a big fan of Dan. Doesn't appreciate what Dan does.
By the way, Dan, I got to say this really quick. Uh-oh. I'm really sorry. So I'm shopping in our neck of the woods today, right?
And by the way, we should just, for the listeners, we should let everyone know that Dan and Kate live in the same vicinity.
We are a stone throw away from each other, yet we never carpool because we don't like each other.
We never work the same shift.
No, the only time we carpool together is once a year for the TSN golf tournament.
Okay, anyway, continue.
Let's get back to the story here. Okay. So I can't go to a store without saying, oh, do you know Bob McKenzie, Darren Dreger, Dan O'Toole? But I get O'Toole a lot more. So, like, I was at the butcher's, and they're like, oh, Dan likes this type of chicken. I'm like, I don't care what type of chicken Dan likes. So, anyway, so I'm over getting my skate sharpened at one place only, right? It's a little place called Crow's. And it's this little bunker. They've got no windows and stuff. And the guy does my skates perfect every time. But he said to me the other day, he goes, hey, you send O'Toole a message. He said, I did up his glove last year, his baseball. And he said he'd tweet about me, and he never did.
Whoa.
I didn't know their Twitter handle. I went there. They did a great job. I had my my glove that I got.
Amazing. He didn't say it. He said it fun and joking. Okay. But I just wanted to make it more of a, he was serious.
That's a great shop. I brought my glove in that I got for my 16th birthday. I still remember my dad got mad at me. He's like, who gets a baseball glove for their 16th birthday? I'm like, I did? Sorry?
What, your dad was mad? Didn't your dad get you the glove?
Yeah, he was mad I asked for it. Anyway, the webbing broke on it like a couple years ago.
That's the weirdest story ever.
So I brought that in, and they fixed it up. They did a great job. So
they do awesome work.
If you're ever traveling along 401 and pull off in Oshawa, go on the south side of the 401. Crows is there.
Yeah, it's perfect. I love the place.
Are we sure that this is an actual business, Kate? You mentioned it was like a bunker with windows.
It's a very strange building.
Bob McKenzie will vouch for me here. It is a well-known place in our neck of the woods, and it is the. Like, it is a fantastic place to get your skate sharpened.
Now,
sharpened my skates so well that my goal production's gone up this year.
You are, like, hugely into playing hockey. You didn't grow up playing it, though, right, Kate?
No, I played basketball growing up.
Right, right. And so now you're into hockey now. And so, what would you say that your game has improved immensely, not just because of the skate sharpening?
Well, like, tenfold.
I've never heard anyone rave about skate sharpening that much. That's
well,
a pretty good endorsement.
It's a different cut. And you know what? Mike Koska gets it the same cut as me on my skates.
Wow.
So I saw Mike Koska when I was doing the Habs and Leafs sideline, and I went up to him. I was like, just to let you know, we got the same blades. That mean we're just as good as each other? And he's like, yeah, no.
When I get mine sharpened, I just say, can you sharpen them? I don't know if you're...
No. You got to get them profiled, O'Toole.
Dulcie, stick to your ball glove that your parents
you
are disappointed to give you.
Hey, or
I can't show off my skills because I'm just holding up a child, teaching them how to skate. By the way, if you do that, get ready for back pain. I've never had back pain, but if you try to teach a child to skate, oh my God.
That's because you're an old man.
Hey, what? Old man Dulcie.
Does that sound like a healthy cough to you, Kate?
No, he should probably get that checked.
Hey, he's trying to deflect his heart problems.
You have a heart problem? Oh, guys, I told you, stop drinking the energy drinks. And Jay, speaking of drinks, guess what I got you from Chicago?
Oh, yeah, you got me a gift. What did you get me?
I got you a bottle of Chardonnay Mike Ditka wine.
Oh, my God, I'm so excited.
I was going to leave it in the newsroom, but then I was like, no, someone will steal that. I better take that home.
That is so kind of you. I got to say, the Mike Ditka wine is good stuff. Dulcie right now, by the way, Kate, couple of things. You can't see this, but Dulcie's raising his arms like he's furious that you didn't get him anything from Chicago.
No, but O'Toole, I'll get you something nice. Don't worry. I'll get Sam to sign something for you, okay?
Probably the more disturbing thing, Kate, is that Dan's pits look like the Nile right now. They're like,
I'm airing them out.
I don't want to know what Dan's pits look like.
Dulcie's pits are just like a couple of Muskoka lakes right now.
That's disgusting.
I'm doing the chicken dance, Jana. Get some air going.
So, Kate.
What was that?
That was the chicken tonight theme, Kate. Do you remember that?
No, but I heard you guys talk about, what were you talking about? The gum that I used to chew all the time.
Big League Chew.
Big League Chew. I ate Big League Chew. Like, I would eat, everyone will vouch, my mom will vouch this. I used to eat like 2-3 packs of that a day.
Your
didn't
mom.
Didn't really help with my
But I find with that, and if you chew a Hubba Bubba, a bunch of pieces, your jaw starts to hurt.
No, a Big League Chew is way better than Hubba Bubba.
So, Beirness, quick question. Biggest surprise for you? In the first weekend, I guess it wasn't the first weekend. I hate that they call it the first round, the second round now. Does that bug
know,
you as much
the worst,
as bugs me?
The play-in games of the first,
yeah.
I know. Hands down, Florida Gulf Coast.
Right, that's the big story.
And you know what? Like these kids, this is just the best thing ever. Oh, I'm sorry, my husband's phone's going off.
Oh.
They won a big hockey game today. He's getting phone calls all day.
Oh, I thought maybe he was being called to a fire. He's a fireman
no,
for our
he's not getting called
know.
To a fire. They don't get called to a fire.
They don't.
They
don't just like on their phones. They just go, hey, Andrew, come.
Hey,
there's a fire somewhere.
Yeah, I'll get there. Okay, anyways, back to my story here. I love this team. Did you notice, though, that they stopped showing Andy Enfield's wife?
Why?
So the first night they showed her all the time,
hey,
right?
This is the coach you're referring to. His wife is a former Maxim model.
Yep. Correct. And now they have three children, and they're a lovely family. Andy Enfield's got a great backstory as well. Anyways.
He's rich. That's why I got her.
He's very rich. And needless to say, so they showed her a ton the first night. And then I think it turned into like, oh, we don't want this to end up like AJ McCarron's girlfriend.
Oh,
you remember
right.
the BCS championship there?
Yes.
So I think basically what happened was the second night she's like, I don't know. I mean, I'm speculating, but they've had to have said something like, okay, let's lay off showing, because they showed her like five times the first night.
Yeah, that does make,
you know, everyone
make
on
sense.
That everyone on that team is older than their school. Their school has only been around for like 16 years.
Isn't it like six
have
years?
Have you guys Googled the campus?
Yeah, it's on a beach.
Oh,
it's at
unbelievable.
Fort Myers, right?
Yeah, it's incredible.
Oh, man. Yeah, that's.
I might go
good.
Back to school.
Maybe you should, Beirness.
Maybe I should.
What would you take?
I don't know, something cool, like chemical engineering.
Maybe skate sharpening.
No way. I leave that to crows.
And you could work in that dungeon that old guy works at. I don't believe it's a business, Beirness.
No, trust me, it is a business.
I'll pull up a Google image here for him.
And trust me, Bob McKenzie will back me up. His son, Sean, used to work there.
Yep. Oh, yeah. We were talking about Sean last week. Sean's been hired by a competing network.
Needless to say, you can ask any of them.
All right, I believe you, Beirness. Beirness, all right, we're going to let you go in and finish the rest of your delicious blizzard.
My blizzard's completely melted now.
Okay, we ruined that. All right, we'll get you another one next time you're in.
Thanks for ruining my night.
Okay, wow, you really ruined it. Good luck, Beirness, and finally, Newfoundland Raider will hopefully leave us alone.
Yay, probably not. He'll probably be asking for the next time I'm on.
Good luck this weekend, and try the lean. Try the lean for us.
I will. I'll tell Sam you guys say hi.
Okay, please do. See you, Kate.
Okay, bye, boys.
Bye.
There we go. There's Kate Beirness. We finally had her on the show. She's good people. When are you going
to
go?
Oh, I forgot to ask what they got for catering.
What?
They've had catering the entire time.
What?
For their coverage, NCAA coverage.
That was a really important question to you, wasn't it? You're really upset we didn't ask that.
So there's a picture of James Reimer inside Crows. I can't get any exterior pictures.
Wait, James Reimer went there?
I tell you, this place is famous.
Old Crowsies. The Crow's Nest.
Crow's Nest Pass. Have you ever been there in Alberta?
Of course.
It's right next to Frank Slide.
Yeah, that's right.
Where a mountain fell on a town and they didn't even dig it up.
Well, what were they going to do? What are they going to do?
The highway is over top of this fallen mountain. So you're like, we're driving over homes? Yeah, essentially.
Yeah, and it could happen any other time. It could happen to any of us. They'd probably dig us up, though.
Crow's Nest Pass is a big snowmobiler's like paradise.
So, okay, now we have another guest. We're getting through them, and we have, I believe, a relative of Dan O'Toole on the show, and this guy's just a treat.
Last week, we described how the O'Toole family, we weren't allowed to listen to Three's or watch Three's Company.
Which is so weird to me.
So
I don't understand this
the
at all.
Oldest in the family, Sean, who's 10 to 15 years older than me, so he will...
10 to 15? You're not 100% sure?
He's not that old, but... He would know better than me. Sean, why weren't we allowed to watch it?
Well, it's because there was two women living with a man, and that was just not right.
Is that true, Sean? Is that why?
Absolutely, because I asked my mom, like, Mom, like, there's nothing wrong. There's nothing going on there. And she's like, it's just not right. And if they were married, it'd be a different thing, but you can't watch that.
What else was on the ban list?
Starsky and Hutch.
Why? Why was that on the ban list?
I don't know. It might have been, what was his name? Sugar Bear or whatever?
Oh, right. Huggy Bear.
The drugs.
Oh, the drugs, right.
But we were allowed to watch Dukes of Hazzard.
Yeah, but they weren't living in sin.
See? I told you could explain it better.
Well, that makes perfect sense, Sean. It makes perfect sense.
How was that? Sean has season tickets to the Vancouver Canucks, and last night the Canucks and Columbus Blue Jackets played to a 0-0 tie, and then they went to a shootout. Sean, I talked to him before the game. He explained how he did not want to go to the game, but he was taking... my nephew Mike, his son, and it turned out great, though, right? It was an exciting game?
At the second intermission, I called a shootout, the way it was going. The most entertaining thing was everyone emulating Jay Thane Vrbovsky.
Oh!
Oh!
Like in the crowd? People were doing it?
In the crowd. Yeah, there was a gentleman behind us in a Canucks jersey, and he had a white captain's hat on. He was the most entertainment of the night. And the loud Bobrovsky came out repeatedly, and he did put on a performance. But I was amazed that you guys could come together with some highlights for the show last night.
The weird thing is the highlights seemed more exciting than the actual game was. I don't know how we pulled that off.
Well, we summed up a 60-minute game in 1 minute, so we could make anything exciting in that.
My jaw was sore from yawning.
It was a snooze fest.
It was brutal.
Sean, thanks for coming on.
All right, glad to help out.
Okay, we'll come back and check some more facts another day.
Okay, take care.
That's, bye, Sean.
Sean O'Toole lives in Vancouver, and so that
someday. All right, I know. I didn't mention it while he was on the line, but someday, maybe our last podcast ever, he'll tell the story, the pig story.
The pig story.
I want him to tell that story.
Our last stop 1 year on the craft tour was New West, so Sean came out, and we had a few cocktails, and he came back to the hotel, and he had finally got into the pig story. It takes a couple hours to tell. And something happened. We had to go somewhere, and we got cut off halfway through.
What happened was... It was my birthday.
Yeah.
And you guys were filling me full of tequila.
Yes.
We went to the keg. I don't remember leaving the keg. I remember you were sending shots over to the table. And then at one point, I was in the bathroom for a long time.
Yeah,
but not puking.
Checked. We checked on you. You're okay.
I literally don't remember how we got from the keg back to the hotel.
We made sure you got home safe.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then we went to a club in New West.
That was a different night. The murder club?
That was the previous night in which producer Tim, so we were there with Slobo, our lighting guy, a couple of other crew members, and Tim's like, okay, we're going back to the hotel. We're like, okay, have fun with that. He's like, no, we're going. I'm like, and Slobo has an accent, so he said, what are you, our dad? And he's like, no. He made us leave. He thought we were in danger for our lives.
It was pretty scary, though.
No.
Remember Bud, our bus driver, who used to, he was like a biker.
Yeah.
And he went up to the door, and they were like, do you have any knives on you? And he's like, yep. They're like, well, you can't come in with that. He's like, all right, see ya. And he just turned around and left.
He also can put cigarettes out on his tongue.
That's a fact. Bud, our bus driver on the craft tour, will, on cue, if you just come up to him and say, will you put a cigarette on your tongue, he'll do it. It's actually really disturbing.
I realize that Sean and I kind of sound alike.
Yeah, you're related. That's pretty normal, isn't it? I can't wait to get the feedback from people about Sean O'Toole. I'm absolutely delighted about that.
I've never met someone who has season tickets to a team and hates that team as much as he does.
There's not a big Luongo fan. Not a fan of Luongo anymore.
It's just...
Or has that waned? Does he come around on that?
He was okay at the start. Canucks were actually playing some exciting hockey. Now they've gone back to the just boring snore fest. Yeah.
It's pretty snooze-worthy. I don't think it would matter if they were winning. Well, they've won 5 in a row, so they're winning now, but...
And all the beat reporters and all the TV reporters, they were all tweeting last night, and they were all in unison saying what an atrocious game it was. And again, when I say last night, I mean Tuesday night.
Tuesday night, right.
Because we're taping this on a Wednesday.
I will say this. At some point, we have to get into the level of volume in the Western Canadian rinks, not including Winnipeg. Edmonton, Calgary, Vancouver. At some point, we need to have a roundtable discussion about this.
Toronto included in that mix.
Absolutely agree.
Toronto is just abysmal.
Ottawa.
What was that?
What? What did I do?
You just like burped on air.
No, I didn't.
Oh. I thought you did.
Did I?
I heard a...
Oh, that was probably just me swallowing. I don't think I burped. I would tell you if I did. Well, we'll go back. We'll check the tapes.
Do you ever choke on your own saliva?
Okay. You know, Tulsi.
What? I'll be sitting on the couch and all of a sudden I'll be like, and I'll like almost die.
Old man Toolsy.
That never happens to you? Do you?
Jimses?
LeBron Jimses?
Jimses?
Big glue glass. Wow, the Red Bull's really kicking in now.
Yeah, it sure is. It really is, Toolsy. We're just waiting for Jeremy Taggart. I think he's at a Raptors game. That's why we probably can't get a hold of him. We might not have old man stories this week. Once again, another tweet. What is Iggy's pencil collection all about? Apparently, Jermaine told us that he really doesn't like talking about it, eh?
But why wouldn't he just put it to bed?
Yeah, I'm not really sure why. What is it about it? Are they like his friends? Is it
my buddy.
They're like his buddies.
My buddy, my buddy, my buddy, my buddy. Wherever I go, he goes. My buddy.
This is weird. Like, he's so protective of his damn unsharpened pencils.
Oh, man. That's pretty funny.
Okay. Shall we wrap this one up? We have a little TV theme vault action.
Oh, yeah.
Can we do that?
Yeah, and by that time, we'll have Taggart on.
Okay.
So TV theme vault.
Okay, before we get into this, oh, thank God I remembered this. And Adrian, I really give you credit for this. Sammy Crystal. Samantha, at Sammy Crystal is the Twitter handle. Her name's Samantha, big podcast fan. I was supposed to say happy birthday to her a couple of weeks ago. I forgot.
You're
Then I was supposed to do it last week.
You're
I forgot then, too. So, happy 2 weeks belated birthday, and does that even count? Can you even get away with that anymore?
Oh, you can. I still have a Christmas present in my trunk for someone, but okay. I sold the car. I hope I took it out.
I don't think you did.
No, I did. It's that bottle of Jaeger.
How great would that be if the 12-year-old just pops the trunk? That's like the greatest weekend of his life right there. Bottle of Jaeger. But anyway, Sammy Crystal, thanks for listening. And her request was Greatest American Hero. The Greatest American Hero. I feel like we might... Have we done this one before, Adrian?
I don't think so. No, never, okay, perfect. Never seen this.
This is a great one. And you may, if you're a Seinfeld fan, you'll recognize this for sure.
Myself. Suddenly I'm up on top of the world. Should have been somebody else. Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. I never thought I could feel so free. Flying away on a wing and a prayer. Who could it be?
Can we cut her off?
This show...
I never saw the show, but I know the song.
You don't remember the show? It was hugely... Again, it's like one of those things that just like came and went so quick. It was on for like 3 seasons.
81 to 83. 44 episodes.
It was pretty funny. It was like a teacher who... aliens gave him a red suit that gave him superhuman powers. It was good. It was a good little show.
It sounds pretty funny. So he hates wearing the suit, immediately loses its instruction booklet, and then has to learn how to use its powers by trial and error.
Right. Exactly. And Connie Selica was on it? Boy, she was a fox in her day.
Speaking of superheroes, I saw a tweet a week or two. It's probably an old joke. But, you know, it's a bird, it's a plane.
It's Superman?
No, but... As the person sending the tweet said, why was the person so excited if it was just a bird or a plane?
What? No, it's just like...
It's a bird! It's a bird!
They're excited. They're just like, hey, it's a bird. Like, hey, it's a plane.
And here's the next one.
Oh, wait, before we get to that, I think Christoph is going to try to find the... So you may remember that theme in relation to Seinfeld. It was George Costanza's voicemail, outgoing voicemail message.
Oh, that's right.
Right, and so it was. I always remember. I was amazed that he actually pulled it off. It really worked well. Not as well as the trade bait. Here it is. Here we go. Listen.
Believe it or not, George isn't at home. Please leave a message at the beep.
must be out, or I pick up the phone. Where could I be? Believe it or not, I'm not home.
What a show.
And then the Jerry called, and then he got the machine. He's like, oh, here we go again. We might have had this one before.
Can okay, we... well, before we get... Okay, Adrian, you spent a large portion of this week compiling... You didn't finish yet. Oh, you just started. So how many have you gone through? What she's compiling doing, she's what? Compiling which TV themes we've done.
Wow, so yeah. You've started cataloging. You aren't impressed. She's like having to listen to the show.
Yeah. She wishes she was sleeping in at college again.
So we've talked about Soleil, right? Moon Frye?
Soleil Moon Frye.
Soleil?
Yeah.
But we never played the Punky Brewster theme. We just talked about
right.
her.
Yeah, I guess so. Did we do Punky Brewster?
Nope.
No?
Let's Punky Brewster it up.
Okay, let's do it.
The show if I heard this theme. You may be lonely and then one day you're smiling again. Every time I turn around, I see the girl who turns my world around.
They had to make the theme long enough to get the dog, the goddamn dog, in the opening credits.
I just remember the show... mostly because of the name of it. I always call my daughter Punky Brewster.
Penelope Punky Brewster is a warm, funny, and bright child. Her father walked out on her family. Then her mother abandoned her in a Chicago shopping center, leaving Punky alone with her dog, Brandon. Afterward, Punky is discovered in a vacant apartment building.
This is such a depressing show.
The building is managed by photographer Henry Wermont, an elderly widower who is something of a grouch. The relationship between the two blossoms, despite red tape from social workers. I don't know why social workers would be concerned about an old elderly widower wanting to take in a young child. As their day in court approaches, the state forces Punky to stay in Fenster Hall, a shelter for orphaned and abandoned children, which makes her realize how close she's gotten to Henry. Finally, their day arrives and the court approves Henry to become Punky's foster dad. Later on, Henry legally adopts her. Soon afterward, they get married.
No.
No, no. Oh, sorry. I made up the last sentence.
That doesn't sound like a comedy.
Yeah, it's a little depressing. Four seasons, though.
Yeah, they did pretty good.
Do you remember Soleil Moon Frye? That was, she was on Friends at one point. It's like one of Joey's girlfriends.
Remember that. You mentioned her in one podcast, though.
She ended up having massive... huge.
I hope to God that's being shortened.
Huge. Like, she was one of the first people I ever heard of who had a breast reduction.
First one in the world.
She had the very first breast reduction in the world. They're like, Punky Brewster, come get your trunk.
Why would the doctor talk like that?
Well, why would you call her Punky Brewster? This is the character she plays. Is this an actor?
What's that?
How is her dog, Brandon?
Do that again. It's the wimpiest dog ever. By the way, that was the worst theme that we've had on TV theme.
Board. That was her. That's her dog, Brandon. When Brandon finds out that her owner is getting a reduction.
So that was that song, Every Time I Turn Around, performed by Gary Portnoy.
Hey, Portnoy, we need you to record something. It's for old Big McGee.
We got no old man story. Taggart's missing.
Okay, I think Taggart's... Poor Adrienne. She's been on the phone trying to get a hold of him.
So, Adrienne, have fun compiling the rest of the TV theme vault.
Oh, were we going to do one more, or do we
just the two?
Oh, right. Okay, so we'll leave that one. So, yeah, I think that's good. We had a good time.
We'll discover that Adrian has dropped out of broadcasting. Her career is over. She couldn't take it anymore. Or she just slept in.
Well, Adrian, thanks for being here. All right. And can't wait. We'll talk about episode one of season three of Game of Thrones next week. That'll be the whole podcast.
Yeah.
Okay.
So have a great week. That guy who we mentioned off the top continue to go to hell. And the rest of you, love you.
Yeah, thanks for listening, guys. We appreciate it.
I'm going to go have myself a Kit Kat Extra Crispy. Twice the crisp. Crisp whippers?
So long.
They're going home.
Hold your head up high dance, for tonight dance. And every night.
Dance.
You're a superstar. And don't you be dance. Afraid. Think of dance. All the friends you made.
Dance.
Like any other night, you've got your name in lights.
Dance.
You're a superstar. Superstar.
This is the J&J.